Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we'll begin with an update on SpaceX's views of the orbital launch planned for March. It's known to all SpaceX fans how much the company is working to make their Starship operational as soon as possible, and we've already known how much the Starship development had progressed in the last 2 years. In 2023, SpaceX teams have completed the most crucial steps before going for orbital launch. Those steps were a full wet dress rehearsal and full-range static fire test of Super Heavy Booster 7, and presently they're working on some other necessary inspections and works such as shielding the mount and so on to get ready for launch. While these progressions are going on, a SpaceX official stated on the 21st of February that with the completion of the static fire test, the company is almost ready for their first ever Starship orbital launch attempt in March. Gary Henry, Senior Advisor for National Security Space Solutions at SpaceX, mentioned that Starship is in good shape after completion of static fire test back in the 9th of February. Henry stated, "We had a successful hot fire, and that was really the last box to check. The vehicle's in good shape, the pad's in good shape." As we know, during the last static fire test, only 31 of 33 engines were fired up. Moreover, as per Musk's statement, the engines were fired at only 50% of their rated thrust. Therefore, there was a speculation among SpaceX fans that possibly the company may head for a second static fire test with higher thrust levels. But Henry confirmed that they have no plans for such tests as of now. He said, "Pretty much all the prerequisites to supporting an orbital demonstration attempt here in the next month or so look good." His statement indicates that the company will directly head for the orbital launch, evidently confirming Elon Musk's March timeline, which he set via Twitter on the 4th of February. Though it's a convention to use a water deluge system, flame trench, or thrust diverter to suppress or redirect the incredible amount of energy that the rocket engines generate during static fire or long-duration burns, Starship stands out as an exception. According to reports, no such systems were used during the recent 33-engine, or rather 31-engine, static fire test. Still, the concrete base of the pad easily withstood the blast of more than 30 engines with just minor damages. This proves how much SpaceX excels in building the pad, and having the pad in good shape will help SpaceX to get ready very quickly for launch by March. Report says that presently, SpaceX teams are now working on installation of a final layer of shielding on Starbase's orbital launch mount. And as per some estimates, the work will possibly be completed within a couple of weeks, and that'll be enough for the launch target by March. As we know that SpaceX is already installing a water deluge system that will eventually make its South Texas Starship launch site much more capable of withstanding the stress of Starship tests and launches. However, installation of that system and building a sufficiently massive water supply will take several months to fully complete. Therefore, it's likely that SpaceX would preclude the water deluge system during the March launch attempt and may use it in further launches after the first one, provided that the first one is not delayed. Henry also specified that once SpaceX successfully carries out the orbital launch demonstration, the company will become ready to move ahead rapidly with operational Starship launches. He said, "We very, very quickly converge on a system that we can operationalize. Starting with launches of second-generation Starlink satellites, we have a few that are waiting very patiently to be launched on Starship." He further explained that those initial launches of Starlink Gen 2 aboard Starship will serve as a test mission. While carrying out those Starlink launches, the teams will gather experience and master the launch and recovery of the two stages of Starship. He also said that somewhere in that journey that will be happening this year, we're going to make a major pivot to the next piece of the human landing system architecture. And that'll be done by demonstrating the orbital depot needed for on-orbit refueling of the lunar lander version of Starship, which in turn will provide additional experience testing Starship through the tankers that will fly to deliver propellant to the depot. Regarding the tanker he mentioned, The nice thing about tankers is that they've got to re-enter as well. We've created this rubric in the next year or two where we'll be able to do a lot of experimentation on that thermal protection system that will allow successful re-entry of Starship. As usual, he also hinted toward the cheap launch price of Starship. We're on the cusp of seeing an opportunity of mass to orbit go from $2,000 a kilogram to $200 a kilogram. If Elon gets his way, you're at $20 per kilogram, he said. Henry pointed out that in the long run, costs could further decline to the point where the propellant is the largest factor in the per-launch marginal cost. During the panel discussion, Henry also mentioned one large obstacle that still stands in the way of Starship and orbital launch. Well, you can easily guess that the obstacle is the FAA launch license. Earlier, SpaceX has announced several Starship launch dates in the past 2 years, but most of them have been delayed mainly due to licensing requirements from the FAA. Therefore, the launch attempt of March is totally on the mercy of the FAA launch license. As per reports, in recent times, conditions between the agency and the company are a bit tense, as the FAA has planned for levying SpaceX $175,000 for failing to submit required positional information about satellites ahead of a Starlink launch in August 2022. But still, we have some hope from Henry's statement at the same conference, which says, "We hope to secure that license in the very near future, probably in the month of March." As for now, SpaceX is more or less technically ready for launch, and once they get a launch license, they'll become legally ready as well. Well, a lot's been going on in Starbase. SpaceX's Dragon capsule, on the other hand, has arrived at the launch site for the Crew 6 mission. With just a few days left for the Crew 6 mission, the Crew Dragon capsule, selected for this mission, has finally arrived at the Florida launch site. According to reports, on the 19th of February, SpaceX delivered Crew Dragon Endeavour to Pad 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. After its arrival, SpaceX shared the photos of Dragon over Twitter. They wrote, "Crew 6 Dragon arrives at LC-39A ahead of flight." Report says that Crew 6 mission is scheduled to launch atop a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket from Pad 39A on the 27th of February at 1:45 a.m. Eastern Time. Earlier, the planned launch date was the 26th of February, but the launch was delayed one day by NASA to give SpaceX additional time to complete work on the vehicle. According to some sources, Crew 6 will be the fourth astronaut mission for Endeavour to the International Space Station. Earlier, Endeavour was part of Demo 2 mission in 2020, Crew 2 in 2021, and Axiom Space 1 mission in 2022. As usual, Crew 6 will send four astronauts, Stephen Bowen and Woody Hoberg from NASA, Sultan Al-Nayadi from the United Arab Emirates, and Russian cosmonaut Andrei Fedyev to the orbiting lab for a duration of 6 months. Report says that Endeavour is planned to dock to the space station on the 29th of February. The capsule will join another Dragon capsule, Endurance, which has taken the Crew 5 mission to the station. Endurance is planned to depart a few days after Endeavour's arrival, carrying the Crew 5 astronauts back down to Earth. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.